Hello everybody, my name is Sean and welcome back to Sean Plays. I think this might be the finale, guys. I think this might be the final episode of Dream Daddy. If everything goes like I think it will, we just finished our last date with Hugo. In between, I got a haircut. I've reorganized my office. If you can see in the background, I don't know if you can tell, I've got my pop figures all lined up now. Everything looks a little neater, a little more organized. I got my record player, my piano, my crazy self. Everything else is good. So here we go. The final episode of Dream Daddy. Maybe. We'll find out. Here we go. Continue. Load. We're in the epilogue. It says epilogue, so this might be the last episode. Here a we a go. Dad tip number 70. Make sure to sweep under your tent so you don't sleep on rocks. That's a really good tip. I went camping one time, and it was fun, but we ended up pitching the tent on a hill, so we kept like sliding down. It was not fun. I mean, there wasn't a lot of rocks, but it still was not fun. Wouldn't recommend it. Ignore the people driving out of my complex. They're loud and annoying. Here we go. Whew. I think I have everything finally set up. Amanda should be here any minute now. I think that's her car in the driveway. Okay. Gotta act natural. Be cool, Sean. Be cool. Amanda walks through the door with a suspicious look on her face. Hey, Dad. Off to a good start. Something fishy? Rats. What? No! You asked too many questions. Sorry, sweetie, it's the feds. That life of crime is finally catching up to you. I tried to send him in a different direction, but even I'm no match for the power and funding of the U.S. government. That's a topic we're going to avoid right now. Well, if they think they're going to take me alive, they got another thing coming. I'm kidding, you're right. I have a little surprise for you. Yeah, I can tell. You're very bad at lying. Amanda, my dear, would you care to join me in the kitchen? Father, it would fill my heart with glee. I lead Amanda over to the kitchen table where a present lies covered under a tablecloth. It's nothing special, but I wanted to get you a little something. You graduated high school last week, and I know you told me not to make a big deal about it, but... Aw, Dad, you... I dramatically whip the cloth off the table. Amanda's jaw drops. No way! It's a brand new car! No, it's probably not that. I figured you probably won't be able to get cable in the dorm, so I thought it might be nice to take a piece home with you. A DVD box set of long-haul paranormal A DVD box set of long-haul paranormal ice road ghost truckers. This is all 19 seasons! And bonus material, including commentary with actual ghosts featured on the show. That's the best. Dad, I love this, thank you. She gives me a big hug. I'm glad you like it. Hey, you want to hang out with me in the backyard for a bit? Toss the old pigskin or something? Totally. I follow him into the back door. Surprise! Oh, and look, Hugo's wearing his shirt. That's adorable. You told me not to make a big deal, but you seem to have forgotten that my entire mission in life is to make a big deal out of your accomplishments. So consider this your graduation party. Surprise! Dad, everyone's here. Well, yeah, everyone wanted to come and support you. Is that a mac and cheese bar? You don't joke about that, man. I would love a mac and cheese bar. Little history here. I'm from Florida, but genetically, I'm from Wisconsin. I don't get blocked up with cheese. I love cheese. Is it a cheese disc? Does it have cheese on it? Could it be improved by adding cheese to it? That is me. You can ask Robbie. Go ahead. Type in a comment on one of his videos. Be like, hey, is it true that Sean really loves cheese? He will respond, hell yes. It's not a problem if it doesn't cause problems for you. I love cheese. Cheese curds, mac and cheese sticks, cheese slices, shredded cheese, fondue. Don't even start it on fondue. Brie, mozzarella, Munster, provolone, Swiss, Gouda. Oh, I love cheese. Amanda, you and I, we are compadres. Not that we weren't before, but we are compadres. Anyway, sorry to derail that. Sure is. Fully customizable down to every type of mac. And there's an ice cream cake, the good kind with crunchies in the middle. Ooh, I like that too. I don't know what to say. Don't say anything. Just go have fun with your pals, alright? I'm so proud of you, Amanda. Amanda smiles and runs to her friends. I should make the rounds and make sure everyone's having a good time. But first, mac and cheese. Priorities. Yes. Yes. Oh, Quizmaster Quinn. Sean. Quizmaster. Hey, who's ready for a crazy graduation party? You don't have to be on right now, Quinn. It's just a party. What do you mean? What's the... You know what? Keep that energy. Hold it close. You deserve it. Just like me and my loving wife deserve happiness, right? You know it. Sean! Brian, you made it! Ah, I don't pass up on good Mac. What do you think of the party? It's not bad. Just not bad? Yeah, it's not bad. Don't let him bait you. Don't let him bait you. Thank you for the lovely compliment. Daisy trots up. Hi, Amanda's dad. Hey, Brian's daughter. See how that feels? This is a really great party. Thank you so much for inviting us. You're very welcome, tiny child who knows how to pay a compliment. Brian and I locked eyes. This isn't over. Hey, bro! Bro! This is a real rager, taking our older age into consideration. I'm trying to be in bed at a reasonable hour tonight. Don't let me get too wild. Don't worry, dude. I'll keep an eye on your fruit punch intake. You know, I'm really glad we're bros again. Me too, dude. My bro. Oh, his other daughters. I never met them. Briar and Hazel pick up behind Craig. Hi, little ones. Hello. Hiya. Thank you for all the nice ice cream cake. Wait, girls, how much of that did you eat? Briar ate 4 pieces? Ask any witness. No, I didn't. Hazel ate 4 pieces and wants to pin it on me because we look alike. I have your face. Nobody will ever believe you. Oh, boy. I'll let you guys figure this out. Good seeing you, Craig. We'll hang soon, yeah? Totally. Tell Amanda congrats for us. Looks like you settled into this neighborhood quite nicely. Oh, we're going to get closure with everybody. I like this. Yep, couldn't ask for a better cul-de-sac. Well, I'm glad. Hopefully we'll see you at more church events. We got a big schedule planned for the rest of the year. Sure thing, Joseph. And maybe if you aren't doing anything later, we could hang out sometime? Sure, Joseph, that'd be great. Well, see you later. Hey, Robert, glad you could make it. I slept with you once and then I never talked to you ever again. I feel awful about it. I'm just eating myself up inside with dread and anxiety. Yep. Robert takes a sip of his drink. Why is it being so cold to me? Everything okay? Sure. Why won't you talk to me? I thought we had something. Come on, Sean, you know what this was. You were an object to me the same way I thought I was an object to you. I figured we were on the same page here, at least from how you were acting. But I don't want to be in this if there are feelings involved. I got too much to deal with as it is. Okay. I'll catch you around. Hey, man. Matt! Let me know when Amanda leaves for college. I'll have a fresh batch of banana bread Kennedy's ready for her. Oh, that's sweet. Thank you. I know she'll love that. What a splendid garden party. My deepest thanks for extending an invitation to my son and I. This icebox cake is divine. Yeah, thanks, dude. Good cake. Thanks for coming by. Hey. I turn to see Ernest, looking like he has something to say. Hey, Ernest. Thanks for being nice to my dad. Whoa. Wow. People are really mean to him sometimes. I mean, I guess I am too, but, he seems happy when you're around, so, that's cool. Well, geez, Ernest, I don't know what to say. You know, I think people got you pegged wrong. You got a soft side. If you tell anyone I told you that, I'm gonna set your trash can on fire. There it is. Also, you don't know me. Before I can respond, Ernest walks away, a cloud of vapor trailing behind him. Well, that was at least a little pleasant. As the party starts to wind down, I take a seat on our back porch step. The sun is setting, and everyone seems to have eaten their fill. Amanda wanders over and sits down next to me. Killer party, Pops. What can I say? I was inspired. So, I also have something for you. For me? Why? Not to be completely genuine about my feelings for once or anything, but growing up wasn't easy, but it could have been a lot harder if it wasn't for you. Dad, you've been there through me through everything. There's been times in my life where you were my only friend. I was really scared of going to college being so far away from you, but I realized that everything you've done for me has been to prepare me for this, and I'm ready. I wonder who I am today without you. Aww. Don't cry. Don't cry. I swear to God, Sean, if you cry again. You're the best, Dad. I love you. And I'm crying. Aww. Anyway, that was enough emotional vulnerability for one day. Prison time! Amanda hands me a tiny wrap package. I tear the wrapping off to it to find a framed picture of me and Amanda. It's us. Kind of shocking, all our photo albums are just pictures of me, huh? I figured we needed at least one together before I leave. Amanda, thank you. Watching you grow up has been the happiest experience of my life. You're such a talented, intelligent young woman, and I'm so excited to see what the future holds for you. Knock 'em dead, kid. Always do. Amanda and I share a hug. This has only been the beginning, Pops. Plenty more memories for us down the road. Memories to make and stuff to break, right? Oh, I'm going to break so much stuff, intentionally and unintentionally. You're probably going to have to pay me for most of it. It would be my honor. Amanda hops up. Looks like someone's been waiting to talk to you. I glance over to the back of the yard, where Hugo is sitting on a bench beneath our cherry blossom tree. He smiles at me. I'll leave you to it. Me and the Emmas are going to go get ice cream. Love you, Pops. Amanda runs off to join her friends. I take a seat next to Hugo as the last guest makes her way out of the party. Cool shirt. Thanks, it reminds me of a special night. Aww. So the secret's out, huh? Hugo likes wrestling. You know, I was really nervous to come here dressed like this, but everyone in the neighborhood, they're nothing but accepting of me and my hobbies. It turns out that Craig's been a huge fan, too. And Colin told everyone at school that I'm into wrestling, but it actually backfired on them. The kids have a weird sort of respect for me now. A few of them even asked me to be the sponsor for their wrestling club. Not the Olympic wrestling. The wrestling that I like. I actually like both, but there's an important distinction, and I think you should know which one I'm talking about. See? Just goes to show there's nothing wrong with being open about what you like. I agree. That's right. That's right. Don't be afraid to be open about what you like. Don't let anybody tear you down. Don't let anybody, like, spread hate, because it's not worth it, man. You only get one life. Why spend so much of it so angry and so hateful and so vengeful about other people's lives that are, at the end of the day, none of your business? Like, really, I just want to touch on that for a second, because it's very important to me. And, like, yesterday, well, this will go out way after the case, so 13th for you, the 13th of this past month. Why? Why breed all that hate and intolerance and anger and just hate and dark into the world, when at the end of the day, what does it matter? Why aren't you focused on living your life and being the happiest you can be? Why do you let someone else's life, someone else's happiness, dictate yours? Be who you want to be for yourself. Stay on your own track. And don't worry about what anyone else is doing. Let them do their own thing. Let them be their own person. How does them being who they are affect you personally? It doesn't. Be your own person. Enjoy what you like. My motto for life has always been this, and I hope you take it to heart, and I hope you spread it throughout the world, because it means a lot to me. As long as you're doing what you love, and as long as you're doing it for good reasons, and as long as you're not hurting anybody else by doing it, go for it. Go for it. If you like wrestling like Hugo does, go. Watch it. Get into it. Buy the action figures. Don't let anybody tell you that it's not cool. That's none of their business. You're enjoying what you enjoy. Do that. On the other hand, if you enjoy hurting people because they're different from you, why? Don't do that. What does them being any different from you have anything to do with your life? How are they directly affecting your life? They're not. And you're taking that and you're playing mind games with yourself or with things you hear on TV, or things you hear in the news, or things you hear with your friends, and just taking it and twisting it and making it, because this person exists, they are bothering my life, and that should never be the case. Ever. Be yourself. Let them be themselves. At the end of the day, I promise you, it's going to be okay. There's no need for any of it. There's no need for any of it. Sorry, I got off on a tangent there. It's just something that's important to me. We're going to get back into this. That got a bit heavy. Sorry. So anyway, Party's ended. We're talking to Hugo. I don't know. I agree. As long as I'm being open, I'm also a very huge fan of very handsome dads who happen to throw great parties for the kid and love a good word jumble. Oh, I blush. And I'm a big fan of... Quick, think of something clever. Hugo's? It's Hugo specifically. Hugo laughs. He drapes an eye around my shoulders and pulls me closer. He plants a soft kiss on my forehead. I'm happy here. Me too. Hugo and I watch the sun dip below the horizon together. Hey, do you think maybe later you could show me some new wrestling moves? Sean, how about I show you my pump handle pile driver? I can't help but giggle. What's that? You'll see. Oh. Alright. Well, I think that's it. Yep. That's the end! Thank you so much, Lightning Gray and Vernon Shaw. Thank you, Tyler J. Hutchinson. Thank you, Aaron Hansen, Brent Lilly. Thank you, Joey Griffiths. Thank you, Greg Batha. Thank you, Eric Itomura. Thank you, Erica Ishii, Barry Kramer, Nathan Sharp, Jason Lardrick, Ray Navarez Jr., Aaron Hansen, Aaron Schmalfield, Crispy Bacon, Brian Wecht, Dan Evident, Susie Burhau, Nathaniel McDonald, Layton Gray, and Vernon Shaw. Thank you, every single person who put their life into making this game and taking time out, because I know three of those people that are pulling out their hair trying to get this, they were pulling out their hair trying to get this done. So we're also dealing with tours and traveling the country to put on rock concerts for people. Like, people that have made this game are amazing. Amazing. It's insane. So thank you so much, every single person who put in work into this game. It was awesome. It was a great story. It was beautiful. So thank you, every single person that put time into this, because you know what, man? It was a great game. Every single character felt like a real person. Every single character had a good background, had some good secrets to learn. It was wonderful. It really was. So thank you so much, every single person who put in work into this. And I'm repeating myself now, so I don't know what to say. But I'm gonna let the credits run. And anyway, this is yeah. My brain has left my head. It's fine. Don't worry about me. Anyway, thank you so much for watching. Please like, comment, subscribe, enjoy this content. Please check out our Discord, check out our Patreon. And thank you really for watching and thank you for being a good person. It truly does mean the world to us. Every single view, every single one. But yeah, we'll catch you later. Till next time. Bye bye.